Hi, this is Dave. Today I want to talk about some modern variations of for Joseki. In AlphaGo's learning tool, these variations are hard to find. And maybe AlphaGo Master didn't play it all that much, but the zero version of AlphaGo played more of that style. But there's no learning tool from AlphaGo 0, so the closest I can get is by using Leela 0. It's not as strong as AlphaGo 0, but it's definitely stronger than humans, and it has a similar playing style. So I used it together with some knowledge I already had. So I knew some of these variations because they're played by modern professional players, and my teacher also explained some things about it. But I decided to investigate it deeper with Leela 0, and I managed to get some conclusions about what kind of variations can be expected. So, what are we talking about? Black has a 4-4 stone, and white approaches usually. Black responds with a knight move, or perhaps a one space jump. With the knight move, the modern continuation for white is to play elsewhere, of course. Play this move, this is common for a long time. There's of course also the slide. I talked about that in my previous episode a little bit. And there's the attachment. Black blocks and white hanes. With the one space jump, a common continuation modern for white is to jump into the corner. I covered some of these variations in my episode about the Chinese opening. And another modern continuation is peeping here. Black, if he connects, white slides, and now black plays elsewhere. I'm not going to cover these specifically. What I'm going to talk about is what if black doesn't really like these variations that I just showed. White jumping into the corner or white attaching here. What can black do about that? Well, black can kick. It used to be a move that was considered bad in many cases when there's no surrounding stones. But that has changed because of the AIs. Maybe not so much AlphaGo Master, but the zero versions show that this is playable. The reason why it wasn't considered good was that now white can make a perfect wide extension, or like this. This is what's considered good for white. And also, if black responds low, the three space extension is the ideal distance from white's two stone pillar. Also, this is similar. It's still considered ideal distance from white's two stone pillar, but the AIs showed black has ways to take advantage of the weaknesses that this three space extension has. So that makes it playable for black to deny white taking the corner so easily. What black can do is black can invade here when white extends low, or black can evade here when white plays high. So when white plays high, black invades low, and when white extends low, black invades high. Okay, let's start from this invasion. What can white do? Well, pretty much the only option for white is to attach on top. Black can continue by going down. Now there is a cutting point in white's position here, and black is threatening to connect here. If white defends against the cut, black connects to the corner, and this is probably a good result for black, taking away all the profit. And white doesn't even have a base. So white should resist, even though it's a little bit difficult. And then black harness here to cut white on the outside. White cuts and can push a few times to make going out here really severe. There are really not many options for white. Black connects here. Now what to do for white? White has to do something in the corner. White plays on the 3-3 point. Now black can choose for territory or influence. This is the move to take the territory. White can play here, but it gives the initiative to black on the outside. So Lila Zero thinks white should play in the center first. Black saves his weak group, and still this is a fight. It's important for territory who gets to play at A. If black plays there, he gets a big corner. And if white plays there, it's no territory for black anymore. But there's also the question of what happens here, this fight. It depends, of course, on the surrounding position. Maybe it's still playable for white. I think in most cases it's better for black to play for the initiative in the center by blocking on the outside, letting white live in the corner. This exchange aims at taking some profit later, and black harnesses on the head of the white's three stones, which is painful for white. And later, in the corner, there's some profit for black. Black can cut here, and black has this nice move to take some profit. If white extends, black can make a go for the life of white's group. So white should capture, but then black has this atari also threatening to make a go. White can connect, but then black gets this connection in center. Now white has to live. So that's some nice extra for black. Okay, so this is a little bit difficult for white to handle. Maybe it's safer for white to play the high extension. I think it's usually safer. Black invades low. It's not so easy for white how to respond to this move. Black is threatening to connect here, to jump out here, and to escape here. So these are three follow-ups for black. What to do about it? Well, the first thing white may consider is denying black a connection to the corner and making black's corner territory insecure. And white may be able to live in this corner. Black jumps out. White can play on top. Black cannot cut white with this hane or the other hane, because white wedges. If black ataris his stone, white connects his group. And if black tries to keep cutting, it doesn't go well for black. White cuts black and captures the black stones. So for that reason, black jumps out, and then white secures the connection of his stones with his wedge. Black ataris, white counter ataris, black captures and white ataris. And if black captures, now white has two cutting points here, and especially with this high stone here, white probably has no other option than to connect here, and black blocks, and this is probably okay for black. I think it's not a huge loss for white. Black's territory here, of course, is insecure, but black took the upper side here. And what does white have is not really a nice follow-up for white. White's position is a little bit cramped. So, maybe possible, but not that nice, the result for white. A better option, maybe to attach on top. But of course then, black is going to aim at connecting at this point. Black can even play some exchanges here. This Hane is painful. If white blocks, black can atari this stone. And if white now again cuts black, we get to the same position as we just had, which wasn't really that nice for white. So another option for white is to connect here, but this lets black connect his stones, and black takes, well, this is not 100% sure territory, but it looks like a decent territory, and white's group is very solid, but there's no base, so I don't really like this all that much for white. Lila Zero often considers this playable for white, but I would feel tricked. So maybe slightly better for white is to extend here, and black still connects his stone. White can cut here. I assume that black continues to connect his stone, and white captures black's cutting stone, making his group very strong. And black secures a large territory. It's more than 30 points territory. I like this for black. Lila Zero thinks it's still okay for white. Probably center plays a big factor here. Lila Zero has one other option for white that is usually slightly better than the other results I showed, and that is to invade the A33 now. It's a kind of a probe. This is also a probe. Black is asking white, what do you want? Then white responds by saying, I don't know, what do you want? They want to base their decision on the response. Probably black will connect his invasion stone, and white attaches on top. Black can wedge here, hoping to make white defend his group here, but white should escape with his other group to deny black the corner profit. Black atari's here, white peeps and takes the right side and the corner. So white is weak here, but black lost all of this profit. So maybe this is playable for white, I think, compared to this. This is completely reversed situation. Instead of black getting close to 30 points, white takes about 5 to 10 points. So black lost a lot of profit. So Lila Zero thinks it's a better idea for black to block in the corner to kill white's stone. This gives white an opportunity to wedge here and make his upper side group strong. It seems to be that Lila Zero considers this a joseki. I wouldn't feel bad with black's profit, so I would say that this probe or invasion looks quite playable for black. Okay, so let's now look at the knight move after the kick. So black plays a knight move. What's different here? Well, actually the variations are quite similar. Let's first look at the low extension again. White plays a 3-space low extension. Black invades high. White attaches on top. And black goes down. If white wants to connect his stones, black just connects his, and white's group doesn't have a base. And black's corner looks big. So white probably should go down to cut off black. Again, black can now cut to white. Hane cuts, push a few times, and atari out. White jumps to the 3-3 point to see what options Black will give him. In this case, with this low stone, Black can choose between the corner and the center. If Black goes for the center, White gets a comfortable life here. Black gets initiative in the center, but this corner is comfortable for White. Comparing this with a similar result when Black played the high move, this variation, White has more comfortable life in the corner. So this is perhaps playable for White. So with a low move, it's probably a better idea for Black to take the corner. This white stone is more or less dead. Now White can choose between the right side and the center. This is the way how White can take the right side. This threatens to do something in the corner. Black responds carefully, and White has some follow-up moves. This is interesting. Black has to go out. White induced Black to make White connect his stones. Black has to go out. White has this cut. Black has to connect here. If Black tries to escape, this is not going too well for Black. So Black cannot escape. He should extend in the center, and then White makes a ladder to capture his black stone. And then Black plays some kind of a getter-like move in the center. I'm not sure if it completely captures these four stones, but it's difficult for White to move out when these four stones aren't even secure yet. So I suppose this is okay for Black. So this move sort of works to take the right side, but I think I prefer Black in the end result. So what else does White have? White can also attack Black's three stones here. Black can push here and still escape. Note this, that this push also kills White's stones here. White extends and Black escapes. White blocks, but Black can easily escape. And it's a running fight between these two groups. I suppose this is an okay result for Black. Unless perhaps this wall makes something really big here. If that's not the case, then it looks difficult for White. So blocking on this side looks correct with a low move. Let's go back to this low extension. It was a little bit difficult when Black played high, but even with the low move, it's a little bit difficult, I think. So let's look at the high extension. White extended high, so Black evades low. Again, Black is aiming at these three follow-up moves. If White attaches on top, Black again has this hane. If White persists in cutting off Black, Black captures, White plays on top, Black escapes, White ataris, Black connects. There's a small difference between the situation where this stone was high. Now White can press Black down. His cutting point is slightly less of a problem for White, because White has forcing moves in this area because of the low position of Black stone here. So this may be playable for White. It depends on the position, of course. So Black can play here, but White has more options now that Black has this low stone. So instead, Black could just connect here. White wedges, Black ataris. White connects, Black connects, and why it plays this Atari on the outside. Again, it seems that Lila Zero considers this a Joseki result. It's very similar to the result when Black played the high move there. That was this position. Again, I kind of like Black's profit. White's group is strong, but this looks like a nice territory for Black. So even though Lila Zero considers this a Joseki, that may be true. But to me it shows that this Black invasion is quite playable. And it doesn't really matter if Black played high or Black played low here. Another option for White is to cut off Black immediately, like this. This can be more of an option when the stone is low. So again, Black jumps out. White could attach here, but White can play some exchanges here first to make sort of a base in the corner. White attaches, Black blocks. White peeps on a 3-3 point. Black connects, and White takes some of the corner territory. Black hannes to deny White taking all of it. White cuts and Black extends to the corner to deny White taking this point. So now White attaches on top and Black jumps out. White wedges Black Ataris. White Ataris. Black captures White Ataris. Black now connects again. White can press Black down. If this is better than this sort of Joseki result for White, I think it depends on the position. But White has more options when Black played the low move. So, a summary. I think this cake is totally possible for Black to play in many positions. It's not so easy for White to handle Black's invasions. When White extends low, this invasion is difficult to handle for White, especially when this Black stone is high, but also when it is low, it's not so easy to handle for White. This can be expected with when Black played low, and when this stone is high, this is also comfortable for Black. I think I cannot really recommend this three space low extension. Playing high looks better, safe choice. And what can be expected is this when Black played a high move, or this when Black played the low move. And I didn't really find things that were clearly better for White. Well, perhaps this might be a little bit better, but it depends on the circumstances. So it's complicated. But I think I showed the basic variations that you may be able to use in your own game when playing either side of these modern AI moves. Okay, thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.